Welcome to Convo and Champagne. This is the third episode. Some of y'all have probably seen my previous work, but this is my most recent one. So I really want to appreciate y'all for stopping by and taking the time out to watch this. So let's get right into it. Turbulence, because sometimes life can just be like when you're on a plane and you never know if, you know, for those who have been on a plane or any type of turbulence when you, you know, sometimes can be a bumpy road or on that flight and, you know, it just never may be smooth sometimes, like dealing with friends, family, or, you know, your coworkers maybe, or, you know, your significant other. So that's the reason why I titled this one Turbulence. So to kind of get right into it, you know, let's start off with that romantic relationship. You know, we know how we love it. Romantic, beautiful, and frustrating at times, you know, dealing with your significant other. You know, as you know, we continuously trying to understand each other and get to understand each other personalities, you know, could be frustrating at times. I mean, to be honest, there's nothing better on earth than a woman. I mean, let's be honest, you know, none of us would not be on this earth if it wasn't for them. So, honestly, I haven't seen nothing that, you know, I feel is more beautiful than a woman, to be honest with you. That right there. Well, that the beauty part is, you know, that romantic part of the relationship is when, you know, they always getting dressed and, you know, they may take a long time. And, you know, it can be frustrating, like I said in the beginning. You know, they come out, they all glamour and looking, you know, fabulous, and knowing the type of meals you may like, and you know, just knowing the things you may want without you telling them, you know, is very satisfying, appealing to, from a male's perspective, you know, and that's the part of that romantic part that we love, you know, and even the times when they may be tired as hell and still willing to, you know, go out or go to the movies, you know, they may have to get up early in the morning. Sometimes they're willing to make that sacrifice for us. So that's that beauty part that we love, you know, in that romantic relationship. I mean, let's think about it. What in creation, you know, from the man above to create something that can birth an actual human being, raise them at the same time. I mean, I don't know what else is more powerful than that. You know, at the same time, you know, they never stop loving us. You know, they have that unconditional love for us, you know, even as a in a romantic way. You know, they love us in the, you know, the physical way, and they also love us, you know, in the unconditional way, which is unmatched. Now you have the beauty part of the relationship, then you have the frustrating part of the relationship, where, you know, they could be very complicated at times, you know, don't know if they're going left or right, or up or down, and, you know, sometimes they'd be very sensitive or, you know, emotional, you know, when, you know, they have that time, but even outside of that time would appear, but just care about things or overthink things that don't really have no meaning for them, you know, and I think that's where we come in as, you know, the protector, or, you know, the person that maybe think a little bit more logical. You know, women think logical too, but it just seems, they may overthink things sometimes, and that's just, I'm speaking from my experience, and overthink it and maybe take it to a level where it don't need. Let's talk about it. You know, some of us being here, some of us may have never been here before. You know, open relationships. Yeah, I said open relationships, or we call them aka friends with benefits. And what we always say, no one's gonna catch feelings, right? And at least one of us wind up catching feelings. From my experience, at least 99% of the time, somebody wind up catching feelings. And this never worked for me on my end, at least. On my end, because I always wondered what she was someone else. I mean, just think about it, you know, if she's willing to just be okay with just doing that and no strings attached, you know, another charming guy or any other guy, maybe he got a lot of money, you know, and something that I can't do, he got all the money I can't afford, you know, spoil her, and they feel that same thing, you know, that's constantly running through my mind at times. Also, I need you to be available at all times, any day when I call. So when that phone goes straight to voicemail, the mind goes to wondering a little bit, you know. I wonder, you know, is she with him, you know, because what I could be doing, he could be doing the same thing. So that's what's running through my mind, you know, because it always seems so peaches and cream in the beginning, but now I'm like, okay, if that was cool for me, it could be cool for another guy. But that's when things get a little complicated, you know, the vibe ain't the same. You know, we're looking at each other, you know, in a different type of way. And that's when, you know, one of us is trying to exit the situation, you know. So, I'm saying, I ain't the one. So, relationship during this turbulence that we may be dealing with is our friendships. You know, now we're trying to figure out who our true friends are. You know, the true friends, you know, from what my experience may be, are when you at your lowest, you know, when you're homeless or even carless, you know, and carless. Even those times where, you know, you may be going through, you know, to each his own as far as depression, you know, and those certain type of friends tend to just stick around. And you'll find out who those type of friends may be, you know, as you tend to go on your journey in life, through your ups and downs, and see who are truly there for you when you're not financially stable, or, you know, whatever, you know, you may be going through in life. So that's what it's like when, you know, you have those type of friends. Friends that you can call or text any time of the day, any time of the hour, you know. Granted, some of them may not be available, maybe at work, or, you know, maybe sleep. But when they're available, when they can get the time to it, you know, they always reach out to you. And you can tell the difference, you know. So, you know the ones where, you know, they're posting every other day, you know, because we live in the social media times now. So they're posting every other day, but they haven't reached back to you 48 hours. I'm just playing. It all depends on the individual, but I'm just saying, if, you know, they out and they communicate with others, they haven't got back to you, that's a sign right there, you know. Not by them not replying, is them, that's a way of them saying that, you know, what the type of relationship it may be with that individual. So just keep that in mind when it comes to relationships. But that's what it feels like with friendships. There are a few friends that they want to see you win. Like, you know, as long as you're doing the right thing, you know, and your head is in a good direction, some of them may not see your quite vision, which most people won't see your vision. They just want to see you win. And, you know, they're very supportive, you know, when it comes to those type of friends. Well, really, to be honest, I mean, I can't count on both hands, you know, when it comes to those type of friends, you know. Maybe on one hand where I know 100% deep down where no matter what the situation may be, as long as I'm doing right with people, that they will be there, you know, and be very supportive. I could probably count on one hand when it comes to that. Now, there's a lot of people who support me, you know, and make, you know, if it were, you know, if it weren't for the support, this won't be, I wouldn't have the energy to provide this. But just saying, as far as friendships, and when you're at your lowest and your highest, they there regardless. Hopefully, you know, that will build, but, you know, I'm just saying, it's time. I could probably count on one hand when it comes to that. And some of them nowadays are like, the friends are, you know, becoming like family, which leads me into my next segment as far as this whole turbulence when it comes to this Convo Champagne episode number 3. So let's get into it. You know, even the times, you know, with family, you know, those times where I may feel like giving up, or, you know, I'm just feeling like this may not be it because I may not be as motivated one day, or you know, my energy may not be as high as the past day, or you know, people not telling me, you know, they're proud of me, you know, and those are just personal things that I may deal with, you know, and some other people may be able to relate to that, but, you know, family, you know, I get the messages from them, and it just always bring me back, and knowing that, you know, my purpose is bigger than me, you know, so that's the reason why family is extremely important, you know, the ones that always checking on you, you know, we have those group messages, and sometimes I can't get back to them in a timely fashion, but, you know, they, you know, just knowing that they're coming through and, you know, nieces and nephews, you know, and just, you know, it's a beautiful feeling to have those type of people in your life. You have to cherish those moments because, you know, nothing is promised. And that's why I really want us to, you know, take advantage of the times we live in now. And make the best of it, you know, and spend the time with your family. Even if you could just reach out to them and text them and check on them, you know, and that would be very helpful. So with that being said, I'm going to go and end it real quick. You know, I really appreciate everyone taking their time out to watch Convo and Champagne episode number 3, Turbulence. I hope y'all really enjoy this. Please subscribe and, you know, like the channel, share it with others. And I look forward to seeing y'all next time for Convo and Tea, episode number 4. Also, if you haven't went to my website, which is fitbetterfast.com, my latest apparel is my pullover hoodies, and I also want to be having these zip-up hoodies too. So if you have my personal number, you can hit me. Let me know what you need, size, color. I'll be able to provide that for you, or inbox me, or you can go over to the direct website. So, you know, fall season is shortly ending and we're heading into the winter season. So go ahead and hit me, and what other better way than supporting a black-owned business and somebody that you actually can get in contact with. So you have that opportunity now. So with that being said, have a great day. Talk to y'all soon. And good night.